Good morning, boys and girls, and welcome to another Sunday of NCKidz. Are you all excited to learn with me about Jesus? For those of you who don't know, my name is Chase. But before we start to learn about Jesus this morning, let's open in prayer. Bow our heads, hands together, close our eyes. Father God, I just want to thank you for giving us this opportunity that we can come and learn about you from the comfort of our homes. Even though the times are extremely challenging for a lot of us and we aren't able to meet in person at church, we know that God, you're still with us and we're still able to learn about you, and every day that as we go forward, we know that you're with us because you're our Father and we're your children and you're the Savior of us all, Father God. And I just want to say that it's amazing that we're all able to learn about you even though there's so much heartache, trouble and worry happening at the moment. But thank you, Father. In your name, amen. So boys and girls, do you all know the story about Passover? Well, if you don't, we're going to learn about it this morning. Passover is a time that is celebrated every year when we remember what God did for the Israelites and when he freed them from slavery in Egypt. But the story starts with the roads to Jerusalem were full with people. Everyone was coming from all over to come and pray and worship and have a festival and a feast during Passover to celebrate the freeing of the Israelites from Egypt. But before this happened, Pharaoh, who is the king or the ruler of Egypt, he however didn't want to release the Israelites because he liked them to be his slaves. However, God said to them that the Israelites need to sacrifice the best lamb possible that they have and sprinkle the blood on the doorposts over the homes of the Israelites. However, the Egyptians, who did not sprinkle the blood over the doorposts, their oldest son, or the firstborn son, would die, which is what happened. But Pharaoh got so mad by what happened that he decided to actually release the Israelites. The Israelites were released into the Promised Land. So during the time of Passover, that was when the angel of death flew over these homes and killed the firstborn son. So everyone was on their way to Jerusalem. Jesus and his disciples were all on way to Jerusalem to be part of the crowd during Passover and praise God. But Jesus wanted to make a grand entrance. So he decided to go into Jerusalem using a donkey. He sent two of his disciples into the town of Jerusalem to ask the owners of the donkey if he could borrow it. The two disciples returned with the donkey in tow. And you know what? They put on their coats over the donkey and put Jesus on the back, and they walked to Jerusalem. On their way into Jerusalem, so many people and crowds of people arrived and started to welcome Jesus. They started laying down palms and started putting colorful coats along the road. It looked like a colorful carpet that Jesus walked on with his donkey. Everyone started to notice and they started shouting, "It's Jesus, the King, the Savior." Everyone was so excited to see that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem to have Passover with them. How exciting is that? Isn't it really awesome that Jesus came to have Passover with them? Imagine if Jesus came to have a celebration with us. How exciting that would be. But as he started to come, more and more other religious leaders started getting furious and angry for the fact that Jesus was getting all the attention. People were shouting, "Hosanna," which means "save now." Because previously, a long time before that, a prophet by the name of Zechariah had warned that a king was going to ride on a donkey in the town. And this was the king, King Jesus. He was arriving in the town of Jerusalem for Passover. And everyone was shouting, celebrating with so much excitement that Jesus was coming. How cool is that? But as we all know, that these other religious leaders wanted to kill Jesus. And that was when Jesus died on the cross. However, a few days after this whole celebration took place, they had a supper, Jesus and his disciples, which was called the Last Supper. During this Last Supper, which is also the Passover meal, they ate lamb, they ate bitter herbs and an unleavened bread. An unleavened bread is a bread that is made without yeast because it gives the Israelites had no time to allow the bread to rise before they freed Egypt. So this is what is done every year. Currently now even, people celebrate Passover with lamb, herbs, and other special traditions to remember the sacrifices that the Israelites had to face and they had to have during the time of being a slave. And this is done every year. And to date, a lot of people are still celebrating Passover. And a lot of for example, the Jewish have a big Passover meal. And during that time, that was when Jesus had his last supper with the Israelites, with his disciples. Everyone was seated at a low table. They celebrated. None of the disciples knew that this was Jesus' last meal with them before he went and was died on the cross. And remember, boys and girls, Jesus died on the cross for us, for our sins, so that we can be here today and be free and we know that he's our King and our Father. And all I want you to remember is that Jesus is there, God is with us regardless of what we're facing. We're all his children and we all walk in this road to him as his Father. And remember, all of you, that I want you all to know that Jesus loves you regardless of whatever, and whatever battle you're facing, whether it's big or small, that he's with us, okay? Because we are his son and daughters. Hope you have an awesome week. See you guys next week. Keep well, keep safe.